In this video, I will show how to graph the quadratic function by analyzing its standard form. In this problem, we have quadratic function written in standard form, and instead of rewriting it in factored form or vertex form, we're just going to analyze it the way it is written. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to find the y-intercept, and the y-intercept is just the value of the function at zero, which is equal to the free coefficient, which is the last number on the right. After we found the y-intercept, the next goal is to x-intercepts, and to find x-intercepts, we have to solve this equation. To solve this equation, we have to solve, we have to set this equal to zero, and we can solve it. The easiest way is to solve by using quadratic formula in this case. So let's set up the quadratic formula. The quadratic formula, when analyzing the standard form, serves two purposes. On one hand, we could possibly find the x-intercepts, but if we don't succeed finding x-intercepts, we can always reutilize the quadratic formula and find the axis of symmetry. So in this case, it actually seems like we can find the x-intercept, so we have negative 6 plus minus square root of 4, which is 2 over negative 2. So we have 3 plus minus 1, which is 2 or 4. To find the axis of symmetry now, we simply consider the expression used to in the quadratic formula without a radical. So, axis of symmetry is a vertical line whose equation is x equals negative 6 divided by negative 2, which is x equals 3. Now, if we know the axis of symmetry, we know immediately where the vertex lives, meaning we know the x-coordinate of the vertex. And to find the y-coordinate of the vertex, we just plug in 3 into the function. So we have negative 3 squared plus 6 times 3 minus 8. So we have negative 9 plus 18 minus 8, it's 1. So vertex is at 3, 1. So now we have enough information to graph this parabola. Let's start with the y-intercept. So it's at negative 8, so negative 6, negative 7, negative 8. Axis of symmetry is at 3. So this is axis of symmetry. Now, if we know axis of symmetry, we can immediately reflect the y-intercept on the other side to produce another point. And we have vertex at 3, 1. So that's vertex. And we also have x-intercepts at 2 and 4. So these are x-intercepts. And now we have enough information. In addition to these 5 points, we can also use the leading coefficient, which is a stretch factor, for improved accuracy. But even without it, we can only draw one parabola passing through all these 5 points. So this is the graph of this parabola.